Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied that what are electrochemical cells, and among that we have studied that what is electrolytic cell. But now we are going to talk about it in a very deep detail by taking an example. So as mentioned on the screen, I have drawn an diagram which is based on electrolytic cell of molten NaCl. And as I said, that for that process we have to apply an external source of battery, if I could say, so as that the non-spontaneous reaction will be converted into a chemical reaction. And in this case we have to apply electrical energy. So suppose in this case I have considered the two electrodes that I should dip, and the two are basically that carbon rods that are being used as anode as well as cathode. So suppose if this is a battery, there would be a positive charge but there would be negative charge. So in this case, this whole electrode or this whole electronic conductor will act like an anode, while in this thing it will act like a cathode. So, and one more thing that I should tell you, that the anode should always be represented on the left hand side, while the cathode should always be represented on the right hand side. So there are a few IUPAC notations that we should go through, and we should follow that rule. So among that, one is that the anode should be always on the left hand side when we are representing a particular cell. So in this case, this is basically anode, while this is a cathode. And since we are estimating the electrolytic cell of molten NaCl, so means there is a molten NaCl which is present in this cell. And since it is NaCl which is highly dissociable when it comes to an aqueous solution or when it comes to an molten solution, so therefore there will be possibility of Na plus and Cl minus all over the solution, all over in the solution. So now let me tell you one more thing. In this case, anode is a particular electrode on which oxidation occurs. And what is oxidation? That we have learned earlier also, oxidation is a process in which electron is being lost by a particular atom, molecule or a substance. While in this case of cathode, if I should say, then cathode is an electrode in electrolytic cell which acts on the basis of reduction, which means this will take electrons, and the one who takes electron will show reduction process. So in this case, anode follows oxidation while cathode follows reduction. So the principle of this cell is basically we have to supply electricity so as the reaction could occur. In this case, the reaction is to separate the Na plus and the Cl minus, because we are giving the energy in the form of electricity, so as this NaCl will get lytic, or this NaCl will get break, so in presence of electricity. So the thing that we should consider here it now, that we have constructed a diagram. The principle that is been discussed already, that is the principle is to convert the electrical energy into chemical energy. And the next thing that we should have a work, that is what would be the working on this cell. So for that, let me tell you, working says that what would be the reaction at anode and what would be the reaction at cathode, and the overall reaction, that is the net cell reaction, will be said to be the work of the cell. So in this case, the working will that could occur at anode would be, since at anode oxidation takes place, so oxidation means removal of electron. So as you know, that if this anode is positive and this cathode which is negative, then which ion will be attracted towards this positive charged anode? obviously the Cl minus ion will go and deposit over this kind of anode, or it will try to attract towards this anode. And what will happen is the electron will get, or this kind of atoms will get deposited or will get liberated on this anode, and electrons are being passed, electrons are being removed from this atom or this ion. So what the thing happens here is Cl minus undergoes a process in which Cl atom is being obtained by removal of one electron. But it is being quite observed that Cl is not quite present in the atomic form, it is always present in the molecular form. So for that thing, what I am doing is I am doing the balance. So therefore, two times of Cl minus will liberate Cl2 by eliminating two times of electron. So this is the process, or this is the work that occurs at anode. Now talking about the cathode, always reduction occurs at cathode, or cathode is a particular electrode where reduction occurs. So in this case, if I talk about, by taking an example of the diagram again, so since cathode is negative, so which part of the ion that is dissolved or that is in the molten state will go and attack towards the negative charge cathode? Yes, obviously it will be the Na plus. So all the Na plus that are present in the molten state will go and will attract towards the cathode. So because, and yes, and the electrons that have been discharged from the chlorine are being deposited, so that it would make the cathode much more negative, and hence the all the Na plus will go and attack towards the negative charge cathode. So in this case, the Na plus will take electron to form elemental sodium or atomic sodium. So in this case, what we can observe is the electron that has been liberated by anode was 2. So therefore, at cathode, the number of electrons that should be gained by the sodium will also be 2, just to make the redox reaction. So, and redox reaction is already been studied in 11th standard. So therefore, we will balance it by making 2 electrons here and 2 types of sodium plus ion, and yes, this will be obtained as 2 types of sodium in atomic form. So this where the working on the electrolytic cell of molten NaCl, but this is not done yet. We have to calculate the net cell reaction. So how can we calculate the net cell reaction? By eliminating the electrons that are present on left side and right hand side. So in this case, this 2 electron and this 2 electron will cancel out, and the thing that will be left with us is this will be the net cell reaction. In this case, 2 times of Na plus plus 2 times of Cl minus will give us 2 times of Na plus Cl2. I could write this equation as 2 times of NaCl, that is giving us 2 times of Na, that is sodium, plus Cl2. So this is how we have applied electricity so as to separate this 2 atoms, or these two elements, that is sodium and chlorine. So in this case, what we can observe is all the chlorine gas which are being deposited on the anode liberates in the form of gas, because chlorine is present in gaseous form, while all the sodiums which are present in an ionic, or which are present in an aqueous solution, are in this case it is present in molten state. So all the sodium plus ions will get and deposited in a solid form on this particular carbon made cathode. So by the help of this, we could separate the Na plus and the Cl minus. So this was the principle which was based on electrolytic cell, that is to apply current and to give a chemical reaction, or to separate a chemical reactant or an electrolyte. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood that what is electrolytic cell of a molten NaCl. And this kind of example you could try for the KCl solution also, as well as MgCl2 solution also. It's very much simple and I hope you have liked this thing. And please share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.